Jordan, go ahead.
My name is Jordan Hevenor. I'm a resident of Wakefield, and my representative is Teresa Tansey. And I'm here tonight to support H5127, the Reproductive Health Care Act. The women of Rhode Island can't afford to wait and see what will happen at the federal level. With mounting attacks on abortion access and the shift on the Supreme Court, it is imperative that we take action in this state of Rhode Island, that we affirm the right to abortion. 46 years ago, the Supreme Court affirmed the right to abortion in the groundbreaking case of Roe v. Wade. Over the years, this case has resulted in legal arguments and policy debates, but for me, the issue is personal. The people who have worked to push abortion care out of reach seem to forget a simple fact. When abortion care is not legal, it forces many people into desperate and harmful situations. Before Roe and the ability for women to get safe abortion care, every large hospital across the country had a special section for women who were suffering from infections from improperly performed abortions. An estimated 5,000 women died every year. The iconic image of a coat hanger did not happen by accident. Women drank household chemicals or tried to throw themselves downstairs, or in many cases, to use a sharp item like a coat hanger. This not only resulted in death, but also in infections, and in some cases, a loss of the ability to have children in the future. As is often the case, women already living on the margins with the least access to care, who were already struggling to get by, were hit the hardest. The mortality rate for Black and Hispanic women was 12 times higher than the mortality rate for white women. Women died alone in hotel rooms and dorm rooms. They suffered in silence with complications that resulted in permanent injuries because they were afraid to ask for help. This is what we could face again, and we know who will be hurt the most. Women with money have always been able to get an abortion if they need one. Before Roe, they could find a trained physician who was willing to help for a high price, or they could travel to another country where abortion was available. People without means don't have that option, and undocumented women would not be able to do so, not only for financial reasons, but also the threat of trying to cross borders and being detained and separated from their families. It is women of color and young women, immigrant women and low-income women who face the greatest risk if we allow the clock to be turned back by an extremist Supreme Court that does not support the right to privacy and the critical right to safe, legal abortion care.
Jordan, we're at 2 minutes. If you could wrap it up, that would be great, please.
The Reproductive Health Care Act would affirm the right to abortion in our state. We have a chance to pass this important legislation this year. We oppose the weaker alternative, H5125. At this point, this legislation falls short. We also oppose H5114, H5198, and H5199. Thank you for your consideration.